Jesus. so bad? Air conditioning. This is beautiful in here. Anybody who walked in here knew this. But they just need to know that I'm excited about it. Oh, I love it. Okay, get your bulletins out. Let's follow along. We've got all kinds of stuff to go over today. Next Sunday is our South Bend First featured families. We've got three families for you to meet. Brenda's going to have tables with balloons out in the foyer, so make sure you take time after service to greet them, get to know them, ask them crazy questions, what's your favorite cookie, whatever you want to ask them. Get to know your South Bend First family. I don't even know who the families are right now, so you get to find out next week. This is really exciting. And then, let's see, Youth Group Water Wars is in 2 weeks from today. And where's Terry Minnix? You're welcome to come and join in the dodgeball and all that. Yeah. Well, you know, whatever we play, kickball, dodgeball. He was like, can I come? And I was like, yeah, come hang out with us. Quiz Retreat is August 20th and 21st. If you haven't registered your student, 6th graders through 12th graders, make sure you sign up. The link is on my personal page and the church's page. You can find that there. Children's Bible Quizzing is coming up in September. It's on Wednesdays from 5:30 to 6:30. It's a parent-led program. I know we have a couple of grandparents. They're filling in for some parents, right, Rebecca? That's right. Some grandparents are stepping up so that way we can have quizzing and discipleship class for our young students, 1st through 5th graders, I believe, this fall. So we're really excited about that, too. If you currently are attending one, right, you're here, we'd also like you to serve one. That is something that we feel passionately about, that our people need to be able to attend a service, to be fed, and then to serve in a service in order to reach others and lift others up. And so there's many, many opportunities across kids' ministries, youth ministries, even Sunday school classes that can be done, many, many other ways of mowing the grass. There are so many things that we can do for no matter what your skills will allow. So make sure that you consider attend one, serve one. And then our quilt makers are working on quilts again. That is really exciting. They have them back in the building on Thursday evenings. Judy's here somewhere. Hi, Judy. So Judy, talk with Judy or Joellen if you're interested in making a quilt. They taught my son when he was 18 to make a pillowcase with a sewing machine. And he brought his own sewing machine. It was really cute. So make sure you talk with them. And then just so you know, Sam's graduation party, we had to cancel tonight because Sam was sick, but now Ben is sick. And I don't want people to come into my house and get sick. So we'll find another day for you to come over, and besides, the pool's not working anyways. So one last announcement. This is exciting. Our ornaments have arrived. I know you can't really see them from where you're seated. Chuck can, though. He's excited.
Wow!
So if you have ordered one before last Sunday, I have your name on yours. See me at the Welcome Center. If you want to see them up close and personal, see me at the Welcome Center after service. They're $15. They're to celebrate our centennial and our centennial celebration. If you look at the back of your bulletin, did you guys look at the back of your bulletin? This is really exciting. We have the president of Nazarene Bible College coming to hold a revival service for us. So this gives you more information about our centennial service, October 1st through 3rd of this year. Bill has an announcement. It is called.
Well, good morning, all of you. I've already had two women steal my thunder this morning. There's one of them. As you can tell, I was going to give you a hearing test. I was going to say, what can't you hear today? It's a fan at the doorways. We have one unit for the sanctuary, the one behind my up to my left. That's operating today. Hopefully by noon tomorrow, the one to my right will be going. So bring your parkas next week. Okay? And then we're going to concentrate on the Family Life Center units throughout the rest of the, hopefully, half a week. Hopefully we'll be done by Tuesday or Wednesday, okay? The update I'm giving, last week I gave you a figure of $17,350. I'd like to thank the person who gave $11 because that's all we went up. $17,361. We have a ways to go. We want to thank that person for $11, so it's not a wasted week in giving, but we still have a long way to go to pay for these units. And the 30-day net starts probably this Wednesday when they finish everything up. So ask the Lord, what do you have you to give? And dig down deep, because this is something that's off our budget. We're relying on God's people to come through. And once again, I'd just like to say, may God bless you.
Thank you. I invite you to stand again with me. Romans chapter 11, verses 34 through 36 says, "Who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor? Who has ever given to God that God should repay them? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be the glory forever."
Thank you.
To speak the words that need to be said to each one of us, Lord, in your name we pray.